teams. This is Aaron. We are going to tell you all about hurricanes. Have you ever heard of a hurricane?
Yes! A hurricane is a huge storm with speeding winds and lots of heavy rain. Did you know that scientists call them tropical cyclones?
A huge storm? How huge?
Absolutely massive! It can be up to 600 miles across and have strong rolling winds. These winds can reach speeds of 75 to 200 miles per hour.
Wow, that sounds very scary. How do hurricanes form?
Hurricanes form over the ocean water of the tropics. Hurricanes only form over really warm ocean water of 80 degrees Fahrenheit or warmer.
The tropics?
Yes, the tropics is the area near the equator. Do you know that imaginary line drawn around the center of the earth?
Ah yes, so it's very warm there?
Yes, very hot. Hurricanes form over the warm ocean water of the tropics. When the warm, moist air over the water rises, it is replaced by cooler air. The cooler air will then warm and start to rise. This cycle causes huge storm clouds to form. Did you know there are lots of different parts to a hurricane?
What do you mean?
Well, a hurricane has an eye.
An eye, can they see? Ooh, I'm a one-eyed hurricane.
Not that sort of eye. The center of the hurricane is called the eye. It is very calm. There are no clouds and the area has a very low air pressure. The most dangerous part of the storm is just on the edge of the eye. It's called the eye wall. It's called a wall because it's made up of very heavy clouds. The wind here can reach up to 160 miles per hour.
I'm not like to be in the eye wall. It sounds super dangerous.
It is. There are also parts called rain bands. These bands can cause massive floods when a hurricane reaches the land. They can drop lots of rain.
Aaron, you said hurricanes form over the ocean. So how do they cause so much damage?
When they get lots of power, they can strike the land. The damage is usually caused by massive flooding and a storm surge.
A storm surge? What's that?
A storm surge is when the water levels in the ocean rise along coastal areas because of a powerful storm. This can cause flooding. Hurricanes can also cause damage with high-speed winds. These can blow down trees and even blow the roots off houses. Sometimes hurricanes can even create small tornadoes as well.
So, when do hurricanes strike?
The Atlantic hurricane season is from June 1st to November 30th. But most of the hurricanes occur during the winter months. The Eastern Pacific hurricane season is from May 15th to November 30th. So how do you know how strong a hurricane is? Well, hurricanes are measured by the speed of winds within them. For example, Hurricane Category 1, 74 to 95 miles per hour. Category 2, 96 to 110 miles per hour. Category 3, 111 to 129 miles per hour. Category 4, 130 to 156 miles per hour. Category 5, 157 or higher miles per hour. So Category 5 is the worst? Yes, definitely. One of the worst hurricanes in history was the Galveston hurricane in the 1900. This devastated the city and killed between 6,000 and 12,000 people, mostly from drowning. The 1970 Bola cyclone that struck Bangladesh killed over 100,000 people. Cyclones, hurricanes, and typhoons are just different names for the same thing. So how big can hurricanes get? It can be up to 600 miles across and have strong winds spiraling inward and upward at speeds of 75 to 200 miles per hour. Each hurricane usually lasts for over a week, moving 10 to 20 miles per hour over the open ocean. The largest hurricane on record is Typhoon Tim, which occurred in 1979. With a diameter of around 2,220 kilometers. It was nearly half the size of the United States. Typhoon Tim, do all hurricanes have names? Yes. Who names hurricanes? Hurricanes in the Atlantic are named based on a list of names given by the World Meteorological Organization. The names go in alphabetical order. So the first storm of the year will have a name that starts with the letter A. There are six lists of names, and every year a new list is created. I've heard of hurricane hunters. Who are they? The brave hurricane hunters work for the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, NOAA. Each mission lasts about 10 hours, with the crews passing 4 to 6 times through the storm. The planes carry radar, sophisticated computers, and weather instruments that determine characteristics such as temperature, air pressure, wind speed, and wind direction inside the hurricane. By mission's end, NOAA can warn everyone in the hurricane's path. Wow, they really are brave. So when was the last big hurricane? Hurricane Andrew was a Category 4 hurricane in 2005. So it was at the start of the season because of the kids with the letter A. Exactly. Well, I've learned so much about hurricanes. Thank you, Aaron. My head is whirling like a hurricane of facts.
I hope you enjoyed learning all about hurricanes. Don't forget to give us a like and subscribe. Please visit us at www.learningmoo.com.